إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today is a day of Thursday, 28th of Ramadan, the year of 1441 Hijri, related to Thursday, May 21st, 2020. And we are still in the month of Ramadan. We are still in the end of the month of Ramadan. وَقَدْ قِيلَ إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ. And it's been said that indeed the deeds are those that you end up with. فَعِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ رَمَضَانَ يُوشَكُ قَدْ يَنْتَهِي. The month of Ramadan is about to leave. And Ramadan, as some scholars they call it, is like a guest. The guest, when it comes to you, no matter how many days will stay with you, but for sure one day will leave you. This is what happened to the month of Ramadan, ibadallah. In the last week of the month of Sha'ban, all of us, we are wondering, asking, preparing, looking how to spend the month of Ramadan, how this month of Ramadan will be, especially in the condition of the COVID-19. How can we fast Ramadan without attending the Salat al-Jama'ah, or Salat al-Taraweeh, or Salat al-Tahajjud, or Salat al-Khams? How we can do this? How we can do that? But alhamdulillah, inna fi deenina yusr. Indeed, in our religion, there is facilities and there's a lot of ease. Alhamdulillah, we could pray in our home. We could pray with our families, the 5-time daily prayers, along with the Taraweeh, along with the Tahajjud, along with the recitation of the Quran. Ibadallah, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنَحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the one who act, the one who do righteous deeds and actions, whether it's a male or female, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate and he will make his life full of happiness. We used to hear in the month of Ramadan, man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام أو من سيقوم ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. We used to hear in the month of Ramadan the famous hadith. The one who fasts the month of Ramadan with faith and expecting, hoping the rewards from Allah, Allah will forgive his sins. Allah will forgive his past sins, ibadallah. and the one who stand at night with faith and hope in the reward. Ibad Allah, the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will erase his previous sins. And the one who stand and who will stand will witness the Laylatul Qadr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us among those who witnessed the Qadr. All they still have a chance today or tonight to witness, which is the night of the 29th Laylatul Qadr. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase his past sins. Naam ya Abdullah. We used to hear all this ayat, all this ahadith and ayat. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبِيِّنَاتِ. The month of Ramadan is the month that Allah descended the Quran as a guidance and clear evidence for people. فَالصِّيَامُ لَا يَنْقَطِعْ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Fasting will not stop just after Ramadan. Means fasting, it's not prescribed or recommended only in the month of Ramadan. When the month of Ramadan is a fast, is a must. Lakin after the month of Ramadan is recommended, ibadullah. Qiyamul layl is not, you won't gonna stop even after the month of Ramadan. The sadaqah and zakat and Quran recitation, you won't stop after the month of Ramadan. فَلَسْنَا عِبَادُ رَمَضَانِ. We are not those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the death will come to us, ibadullah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And all what did you build, and all what you done in the month of Ramadan, this is will be written under your record, ya ibadullah, ya abdullah. As the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمْ إِنْ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. When the son of Adam will pass away, all his deeds and action will be stopped and interrupted except three things. قَالَ صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ. It continuously sadaqah. Beneficial knowledge he left it behind him. And a pious child, whether a boy or a girl, will make dua for him. Allah or for her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it. فعباد الله يقول قال أحد السلف إن الدنيا مبنية على آيتين. He said this life is built upon just two ayats. Then after he recites, the first ayah is فمن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى. And the second ayah is, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Ibad Allah. One of the Salaf, he mentioned that these two ayahs, that he said, this dunya, or this life, included Ramadan, included Sha'ban, included Rajab, included the whole year, that we are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More farther is for your whole life. Is these two ayats. فَمَنِ اتَّبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. The one who follow my guidance, the one who follow my revelation, the one who take the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as an example in all his matter, عباد الله, he will never be misguided. He will never be misguided. He will never be astray. Then he said, in the opposite side, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. And the one who opposed against my remembrance, against my message, against my revelation, indeed, he would face a miserable life. يا عباد الله, my dear brothers and sisters, today, inshallah ta'ala, the most important part of my lecture, which is how can we be protected from the fitna? How can we protect ourselves from the fitna? The fitna that is surrounding us day and night. And no one can deny. And no one can say that I don't know if this is really fitna. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is mentioned, that the most difficult things for a person is when you show him the right, when you show him the haram, or when you show him the evil, and when you show him a good, but he doesn't know which way to choose. So he doesn't know which one he will choose. This is the most of the utmost difficult situation of a Muslim, ibadallah. يقول الله عز وجل ولقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد. A kabad is a hardship. Indeed, we create a human or a son of Adam upon in a state of kabad, means in a state of hardship. Facing a lot of problems, a lot of situation, a lot of fitan, trials, a lot of calamities. Day and night, as I mentioned, whether it's in here or in different lands. And all what the Muslim is facing is summarized upon one ayah, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, to test you, who is amongst you that do or apply a righteous and good deeds, ibadullah. الْإِنسَانُ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا فِي دَارِ امْتِحَانِ وَابْتِلَاء يُبْتَلَى بِالْخَيْرِ وَالشَّرِّ فِتْنَة. We are in this dunya, ibadullah, facing a lot of trial, a lot of tests. And sometimes we are tested with good to see how we deal with. And sometimes we're tested with the evil to see how we face and how we patient and how we push that evil by, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنَبْلُوكُ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. Indeed, we test you, we trial you with the evil and with good. Indeed, are these two our fitna. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, Alif lam mim, ahasib an-nasu an yutraku an yaqulu amanna wa hum la yuftanun. Alif lam mim, does people, they will think, they will stay without being upon a trial? And he said, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Indeed, we test the people, those who were before them. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know those who are truthful and knows those who are liar. And among these fitna that I'm going to mention, ibadullah, in this lecture, the first one, which is fitnatul mal. فَالْمَالُ فِتْنَةُ وَامْتِحَانُ امْتِحَانُ وَابْتِلَاءُ لِلْإِنسَانِ, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So that the first fitna that ibadullah, I want to remind you and to advise you to stay away from it, which is the fitna of mal. إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةُ وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. Indeed, your wealth and your children are the fitna, means it's a trial. If you do know how to manage, if you do know how to use them in a right way or in a proper way, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a great reward. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لكل أمة فتنة وفتنة أمة المال. Indeed, upon every single nations, they had a trial and a fitna, but my nation, their fitna is the mal, المال, which is a wealth. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم also, والله ما الفقر أخشى عليكم. By Allah, not the poverty I scare to happen to you, ولكني أخشى أن تبسط الدنيا عليكم, but I am afraid that this dunya will open up to you as it destroyed the people, those who were before you. فتتنافسوها أو فتنافسوها كما تنافسوها فتهلككم كما أهلكتكم. Then after you will compete each other as they used to compete each other, and it will destroy you after it been destroyed the people, those who were before you. This is a clear message from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also all of us without any exception that we witnessed this situation, either we're witnessing now or witnessed before. فالأولاد فتنة، والمال فتنة، والجاه فتنة، والكبر فتنة. عباد الله، and the second fitna that I'm going to share with you today, which is فتنة الأولاد, the trial of the children. فالأولاد بالنسبة للإنسان فتنة عظيمة. Indeed, the children, it could be فتنة to us, عباد الله, if you do not know how to guide them and how to direct them and how to teach them without affecting our deen and our steadfastness, عباد الله. قال تعالى إنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة. Indeed, your wealth and your children are a فتنة. Because most of the Muslims, they've been misguided and they went astray just because money or wealth, or just because the need of the children. So you see them. You see them deviated. You see them taking care of their children in such a way that they will forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will forget their right upon them and upon their children until they will lead them to misguidance. Ibad Allah. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الدنيا حلوة خضرة. Indeed, this dunya is very sweet and a beautiful. وإن الله تعالى مستخلفكم فيها. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى will create you in this dunya. فينظر كيف تعملون. And you will see how you're going to act. فاتقوا الدنيا واتقوا النساء. So fear the dunya means be careful, watch your steps, how to act in this life. And fear the woman, ibadullah, means watch how to use the woman, ibadullah, how to deal with the woman, ibadullah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described these fitan, this trial. قال فتن تجعل الإنسان يخرج من دينه. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تكون بين يدي الساعة فتن كقطع الليل المظلم. It will be among in the hour of this time, trial is like a part of the darkness in the nights. يصبح المؤمن. And the message of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم give an example of a darkness, because when you walk in the darkness you don't know your direction. You don't see where you are going. يصبح المؤمن يصبح الرجل مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا. The man, he wake up in the morning as a believer and he will end up in the afternoon as a disbeliever. And then likewise, he will be in the afternoon as a believer and he will come the next day as a kafir. As a disbeliever, يبيع دينه بعرض من الدنيا. He will trade his religion, his dignity, his iman, his akhlaq with just issue of things from this life, which is money. Also, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing this dunya, تجعل الإنسان يتمنى الموت. He mentioned that how the trial affect the believer up to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تذهب الدنيا حتى يمر الرجل على القبر فيتمرغ عليه ويقول يا ليتني كنت مكان يا ليتني كنت مكان صاحب هذا القبر وليس به الدين إلا البلاء. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the dunya will not end up until an individual passed by a grave. And he will lie down upon that grave and he will say, I wish I was a man. I wish I was a person. I wish I was in the place of that person. Means the person who is in a grave. Not because of the religion, but because of the trial that he's facing. Also, Ibad Allah, among this fitan, among this trial, there will be a lot of killing. Killing between Muslims, ibadullah, as all of us we witness. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أين إن بين يدي الساعة أيام ينزل فيها الجهل ويرفع العلم ويكثر الهرج، وقيل الهرج القتل. The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, between the hour, in our time, there will be a lot of ignorance, and there will be few knowledge, and there will be a lot of haraj. قيل يا رسول الله, what is the haraj? He said, the killing. ويقول إن بين يدي الساعة الهرج. قالوا وما الهرج يا رسول الله؟ قال القتل. He said, is a killing. إنه ليس بقتل بقتلكم المشركين. So it's not that you are killing other than you. But he said, ولكن قتل بعضكم بعضا حتى يقتل الرجل جاره ويقتل أخاه ويقتل عمه ويقتل ابن عمه. Until a man will kill his neighbor, a Muslim neighbor. He will kill his brother. He will kill his uncle. And he will kill his cousin. ويقول أيضا, and he mentioned also the message of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, والذي نفسي بيده ليأتينا على الناس, ليأتينا على الناس من زمان, لا يدري القاتل في أي شيء قتل, ولا يدري المقتول على أي شيء قتل. It will be a time, and this is a statement from your prophets, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the one does not say things from his own except the truth. He said, there will be in a time upon people, the one who being killed, he doesn't know why they killed him. And the one who killed, doesn't know why he's killing. عباد الله, وقد جاء هذا الزمان, اختلط الحق بالباطل, واختلط الصادق بالكاذب. Indeed, we are living and we are witnessing this time, and there is a mixed up between a trustworthy person and the one who say, oh, the liar person. ومن الفتن آخر الزمان عباد الله اختلال الموازين, فالناس حيارى إلى أين يذهبون وإلى من يلتجئون ومن يصدقون ومن هو الصادق ومن هو الكاذب ومن هو الأمين ومن هو الخائن. عباد الله, in this time, people, they have no direction, no guidance. They don't know how to go to refer to. They don't know who to trust. They don't know who is the right one, who is the wrong one. They don't know which one is saying the truth, which scholars, which individual is upon the straight path. إذا كان العالم يقوده رجل رويبضة فما تنتظرون عباد الله. So when the man or a scholar or a caller for this deen are people of fitna, people has no knowledge, what do you expect from them? And all of us, we witness all the spring Arab, what happened to it? All that fatwa, that call, that guidance, and that many speech being delivered from these scholars of fitna. And look at the results. Look at the destruction all the Muslim lands by those who have no knowledge and no evidence. ويتكلمون في أمر العامة, and they talk in the matter of people. يقول أبو زيد عمر بن الخطاب بن أخطب رحمه الله رضي الله عنه, صلى بنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الفجر. He said, the message of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he pray, he lead صلاة الفجر. Then after he climb on the minbar, فخطبنا حتى حضرت صلاة الظهر. He was talking, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was delivering a lecture until Salat al-Duhr. Then after he came down, then after he climbed back again the minbar, then he was delivering a lecture until Salat al-Asr. Then after he came down, then after he went back again until Salat al-Maghrib, until the sun set. Then he said, فَأَخْبَرَنَا بِمَا كَانَ وَبِمَا هُوَ كَائِنْ فَأَعْلَمَنَا أَحْفَظَنَا. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the man, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us all what happened and what's going to happen in this life until the day of judgment, ibadallah. Fa'ibadallah, كيف ينجو المسلم من هذه الفتن؟ يقول الحسن البصري رحمه الله: نفسك إن لم تشغلها بالحق شغلتك بالباطل. Your soul, indeed your soul, if you do not keep it busy with the truth, your soul itself will direct you with falsehood. ويقول المقداد بن الأسود رضي الله عنه قال: والله لقد سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول وكررها ثلاث. He said, I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying that the fitna, and he repeated three times, السعيد, the happiest person, the one who stay away from fitna, the happiest person, the one who turn away himself from the fitna, and the happiest person is the one who turn away from the fitna, ibadallah. So the first one, ibadallah, to save and protect yourself and your family from the fitna, أن يلزم جماعة المسلمين وإمامهم, and to be surrounded with the jama'ah and the imam, عباد الله. وجماعة المسلمين هي التي تكون على الحق. Indeed, the jama'ah or the group or the minority of the people that you are that those who are surrounding you, they must be upon the truth. وهم الذين على ما كان عليه النبي وأصحابه, and to those that they used to be upon the way how the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to be, and the companions, as the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كلهم في النار إلا واحدة, قال وما هي يا رسول الله, قال التي تكون على ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. He said, is the group or is the sect or is the minority of people those used to be upon my way today and the way of the companions. The second is to save ourselves from the fitna. إذا أردت أن تنجو من الفتن فعليك أن تتمسك بالكتاب والسنة بفهم سلف الأمة. The second point, which is to stick upon the sunnah of the message of Allah, upon the book of Allah, and the sunnah of the message of Allah by the understanding of the companions. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: تركت فيكم شيئين لن تضلوا بعدهما, كتاب الله وسنتي. The message of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, I left behind me two principal, two important things. You will never be misguided. The first one is the book of Allah, which is the Quran. And the second one, which is the sunnah, which is my guidance. Which is my guidance, ibadallah. فَإِنَّهُ يَوْمْ أَن تَمَسَّكَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ السُنَّةِ فَتَحُوا قُلُوبُ الْعِبَادَ وَالْبِلَادَ بِالْإِسْلَامِ. Indeed, the day when the companions, they were sticking upon the book of Allah and the sunnah, they opened up the heart of people and many lands by the Islam, عباد الله. فعباد الله كتاب الله بين أيدينا كلام الله والصراط المستقيم وهو الحبل المتين. Indeed, the book of Allah is between our hands and is the straight path and the strong rope that we need to stick to it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم. Indeed, the Quran guides to which is the best, ibadallah. Thirdly, number three, how to save ourselves from this fitna, ibadallah. فعليك بعبادة الله عامة وقيام الليل خاصة, أي بالالتجاء إلى الله بالعبادة. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: عبادة في الهرج والفتنة كهجرة إلي. عباد الله, the third one is to save yourself from fitna, from the trial, is to continue worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the tongue of the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam command us to worship him and to please him, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, رضي الله عنهم. رضي الله عنهم means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being pleased what they used to do. وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ, and they've been pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ خَشِيَ رَبَّ, indeed is the one who has the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ لَمَّا نُزِلَتِ الْفِتَنِ فَهَلْ صَمْنَا وَهَلْ حَافَظْنَا عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ الْجَمَاعَةِ وَهَلْ قُمْنَا بِالْلَّيْلِ نَرْفَعُ أَيْدِينَ وَنَقُولُ اللَّهُمَّ احْفَظْنَا مِنَ الْفِتَنِ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. عباد الله, when the fitan are surrounding us, we need to fast. We need to increase our voluntary fasting. We need to attend Salatul Jama'ah as much as we can. We need to stand in the night and make dua, recite the Quran, pray in the night voluntary prayer, which is Qiyamul Layl, and to say, oh Allah, protect us from this fitan, which is the fitan that is exposed. And the fitan that is hidden, ibadallah. Rabi'an, number four. إذا أردت أن تنجو من الفتن فعليك أن تلزم بيتك وتمسك لسانك. فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, also the fourth point to save ourselves from this fitna, ibadallah, is to stay in your home if you have no necessity to go outside. And to hold your tongue means to do not backbite and talk and criticize and create fitna and be a supporter of fitna, as the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. لما جاءه عقبة بن نافع عقبة بن عامر رضي الله عنه فقال يا رسول الله من نجات. عقبة بن عامر, he came to the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, oh messenger of Allah, what is the relief? How can be saved? How can protect myself? قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم املك عليك لسانك, means hold your tongue, وليسعك بيتك, stay in your home, means your home is sufficient for you to protect yourself from evil. Then he said وابكي عن خطيئتك, and cry for your sins, means correct yourself, because whenever you commit outside, whenever you go outside with any necessity, for sure you will commit sins. Ibadallah, remember this dua, imlik alayka lisanik, hold your tongue, and your house is sufficient for you, stay in your home, and cry for your sins, ibadallah. And then we conclude the fifth point, al-Muslim, is upon a Muslim to be saved from the fitan, is to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by dua, and to seek refuge and protection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil. فَالدُّعَاءُ يَنْفَعُ بِمَا نَزَلَ وَمَا مِمَّا لَمْ يَنْزِلْ, and the dua indeed will benefit. So whatever been descended to you or didn't descend to you, عباد الله. وَنَحْنُ نَقُولُ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلْكَافِرِينَ وَنَجِّنَا بِرَحْمَتِكَ مِنْ شَرِّهِمْ وَشَرِّ مِنْ أَعَانَهُمْ وَاحْفَظِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَبِلَادِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ جَمِيعًا من شر أعداء الإسلام. وقد علمنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم taught us how to seek refuge and protection from this evil في كل صلاة. فقال إذا تشهد أحدكم, in every single prayer, when we make تشهد means التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات all the way to the end, فليستعذ بالله, he said, we seek protection from evil to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from things. قَالَ يَقُولُ اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ جَهَنَّمُ, oh Allah, I seek refuge and protection from hellfire. وَمِنْ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ, or from the punishment of the grave. وَمِنْ فِتْنَةِ الْمَحْيَى وَالْمَمَاتِ, and from the fitna of the death and the life. وَمِنْ فِتْنَةِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ, and from the fitna and the trial of the Masih al-Dajjal. نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن ينجي المسلمين من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. ربنا تقبل منا الصلاة والصيام والقيام وتلاوة القرآن, واجعلنا من الفائزين في هذا الشهر المبارك يا عباد الله. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين وفقوا في ليلة القدر أو سيوافقون في ليلة القدر في هذه الليلة, ليلة الجمعة, عباد الله. يقول أيضا يا عبادي إنها هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم ثم أوفيكم إياها، فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله، ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن إلى نفسه. عباد الله، also the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O servant of Allah, indeed these are all your deeds and actions. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in this hadith Qudusi, all these actions I will record for you. And when you come in the day of judgment, if you find all these good deeds in front of Allah, be happy. But if you find other than this, do not blame no one. So blame yourself, ibad Allah. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله إذا أحب عبدا ابتلاه استعمله. قالوا يا رسول الله كيف يستعمله؟ قال يوفقه إلى عمل صالح قبل موته. The message of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, I conclude my khutbah, he said that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he loves his servant, he will utilize him. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, how Allah can utilize his servant? He said, He will guide him to do righteous deeds and actions just before his death, and he will take him upon that actions. Allahumma taqabbal minna as-salata was-siyam. Allahumma ij'alna min 'ibadika al-musta'in. Allahumma ij'alna min 'ibadika as-salihin. Allahumma ihshurna ma'a an-nabiyyin was-siddiqin wash-shuhada'i was-salihin wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.